हाय फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर एस मोची, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंटोमोलॉजी, केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नासिक। टुडे आई विल टीच यू द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कंसेप्ट ऑफ योर सिलेबस। द नेम इज कैटेगरीज ऑफ पेस्ट एंड आउटब्रेक्स ऑफ द पेस्ट। बट बिफोर वी स्टडी द कैटेगरीज ऑफ द डिफरेंट पेस्ट, we should know about what is mean by paste. So what is mean by paste? The word paste, it is the French word or the Latin words. In case of French word called the pasty, and in case of Latin word is a pastis. It means that it is a plague or contagious disease. Okay, but actually what is paste? What is the definition of the paste? According to the FAO in 1996, it gives a universally accepted definition in which any species, strain or biotypes of the plant, animal or pathogenic agents injurious to the plant, plant product, man and his interests called as a pest. It means that anything that can cause a yield losses in a field called as a pest. In picture, birds, rats, mites and insects are it act as a pest. And then pest includes nematodes, mites, snails, slugs, etc. and vertebrates like a rat and birds also. Depending upon the importance, pest may be agricultural pest, forest pest, household pest, medical pest, aesthetic pest and veterinary pest. And if you see in case of agriculture pest means are those pests which cause a yield in a our field. House forest pest means which pest which attack on the forest plant species. Then household pest, in that household pest, cockroach. And then we can say that the ants, these are the which loss our kitchen products. Then medical pest means are those pests which carry the disease into the human beings, like a mosquito, house fly, bed bug, like that. Veterinary pest means are those in that ticks, mites are those pests which attack on the veterinary animals. If you see the definition of the pest is any animal, pathogen, insect which cause damage to man, his animal and the crops. Okay. Then if you see the categories of pest, but before we study the categories of pest, we should know about the what is the actual economic pest. Why? Because economic pest means which pest or which cause more than 5% economic yield loss, and that economic pest is considered in the our pest management strategy. Then when an insect is called as a pest, because the universally accepted sentence is that all pests are insects, but all insects are not pests, because in insect there are the some of the beneficial insect also. But which insect is when the insect is called as a pest, how the insect become a pest? Before we start the categories of pest, we should know about the how the insect become pest, and this concept is necessary to study this pest. The concept of injury level. In that concept of injury level, the population or damage assessed from the crop compared with ETL and EIL. Economic threshold level and economic injury level are the most important concept regarding the pest management. When the pest level crosses the ETL, control measure has to be taken to prevent the pest from the reducing EIL. Okay, this concept is given by this Stern et al. In 1959. Okay, in this concept of injury level, this is the first concept. GEP, General Equilibrium Position. What is this? It is the average of the population over a long period of time, around which the insect population tends to oscillate due to biotic and abiotic factors. It means that due to the different biotic and abiotic factors, which we can say that it average number of the population over long period of time, it maintain. That concept is called as general equilibrium concepts. Then damage boundary. It is the lowest level of the damage which can be measured. It means that the pest which cause a damage to the number of plant parts, but it can measure, that concept is comes under the damage boundary. Then economic injury levels. It is the lowest pest population density that will cause the economic damage. It means that It is the lowest pest population density. That population of the pest which can cause a economic damage to the plant. Or it is the critical density of the insect population where the loss caused by the pest equals to the cost of control measures. Then how to calculate the economic injury level? This is the formula for calculate the economic injury level in pest affected fields. We can calculate the economic injury level of that particular pest in that particular crop. This is a simple work examples given here. We can calculate how the number of insects it is in a per hectare area. It means that how we can calculate the economic injury level. It means that suppose this is a 7,500 insect. How these insect are, how much damage is caused by this insect in that affected field? We can calculate. Okay. The concept is a EIL of a pest constant at all time? The answer is no. So why no? Because here the economic injury level is influenced by the different factors. The first one is market value of the crop. It is a primary factor. When a crop value increases, the economic injury level decreases and vice versa. Management of the injury by the insect. When the management cost increases, the economic injury level also increases. A degree of the injury per insects. It is a secondary factor. Insect damaging leaves and reproductive parts will have to differ economic injury levels. For all instance, defoliators will have higher economic injury level. If the insects are found on a fruits, economic injury level is low. And if the insects are vector of disease, economic injury level is also low. Then the crop susceptibility to injury. If the crop can tolerate the injury and gives a good yield, EIL can be fixed at a higher volume. When the crop is older, it can be withstand higher population, EIL can be high. These are some of the factors which influence on the EIL in a particular area. Then last and major concept of the economic injury level is that economic threshold level, and this is the key of economic of injury level. It is a count for control of the pest or controlling or in integrated pest management. What is this? It is defined as the pest density at which control measure should be applied to prevent and increasing the pest population from reaching EIL. This is the diagram showing economic threshold level. Then now, after the insect, it reaches the economic threshold level, then we can go for integrated pest management. Then why? Because that particular insect is become a pest. But now the concept is which pest, which are the different categories of pest. Then now the major concept is different categories of pest. There are the different categories of pest. The first one is the base on the occurrence. In that base on the occurrence, the first one is the regular pest. The pest which occurs more frequently or regularly on the crop and have a close association with a particular crop. It means that the pest or the insect that become a pest which continuously occurs, frequently occur on that particular crop. Why? Because they form a close association of that particular crop. For example, thrips on chili, aphids on cotton, rice stem borer, brinjal fruit borer are the examples of the regular pest which have a close association with their host and occurs regularly. Then based on the occurrence, second pest on based on the occurrence is occasional pest. The pest which occurs infrequently on a particular crop and do not have any close association with that particular crop. It means that these pests do not occur regularly. It occurs in some time or in some area. Why? Because they do not have a close association with that particular crop. For example, caseworm on rice, stem borer on mango, slug caterpillar on mango. These are the different examples of the occasional pest. Next one is a seasonal pest. This is the third pest based on the occurrence. The pest which occurs on the particular seasons in the year called as a seasonal pest. It means that some of the pest occurs in a kharif season, in rabi season and in a summer season. Here the example is the red hairy caterpillar which occurs on the groundnut crop in a kharif season. It is a kharif pest. Wheat aphids occurs on the wheat. It is in a rabi season. These are the different examples. Then a persistent pest. The pest which occurs on the crop almost throughout the year called as the persistent pest. Mealybug and scales on the mangoes and grapes, thrips on chilies and cardamom are the examples of a persistent pest which occurs throughout the year on that particular crop. Then sporadic pest. The pest which occurs on the few isolated locality or patches called as a sporadic pest. Here the galmiz and earheads bugs on rice, slug caterpillar on mango and castor are the examples of the sporadic pest which generally occurs on that particular isolated localities. Then last one on the base of occurrence is cyclic pest. The pest which occurs on a crop once in 8 to 10 years that called as a cyclic pest. Deccan wingless grasshopper are the examples. Second category, based on the level of infestations. In that, there are the two pests, epidemic pest and endemic pest. Pest which occurs on a crop suddenly in a severe form in a locality at a particular season or time called as the epidemic pest. For example, white fly on cotton, sugarcane woolly aphid on a sugarcane. Then next one is the endemic pest. The pest which occurs on a crop in a regular features in a confined area or locality called as endemic pest. Example is gall fly in a paddy. Third category is based on the population and damage capacity. In that, the first one is the key pest. What is key pest? A general equilibrium position is always lies well above the economic injury level in that key pest. A human intervention in the form of control measures may bring the population temporarily below the EIL, but it rises back rapidly. So a repeated human intervention may be required to minimize the damage of the key pest. DBM, it occurs on the cruciferous vegetables or cabbage. It is the most important key pest. Next one is a major pest. Major pest means are those pests which cause more than 10% yield losses in the field. But here, the general equilibrium position is close to the EIL and in some cases, both may be at the same level. So the population crosses EIL quite frequently and repeated control measures necessary, but economic damage can be avoided by the timely intervention. For example, rice stem borer, brown plant hopper on rice, white fly in cotton and leaf hoppers in cotton are the examples of the major pest. Then minor pest. Minor pest means are those pests which losses near about, we can say that the 5 to 10% yield losses. But here, the general equilibrium position lies well below the EIL or even below the damage boundaries. So, only under favorable environmental conditions, the population may cross EIL for a short interval. A single application of insecticides visually enough to prevent the economic damage called as a minor pest. For example, cotton stainer called as a red cotton bug and the Spodoptera litura, tobacco leafeating caterpillar are the example of the minor pest. And then, based on the population and damaging capacity, the fourth category is sporadic pest. In the sporadic pest, the population is visually negligible, also called as a negligible pest. But in certain years, under favorable environmental conditions, it appears in the virtually epidemic form, crossing many times over damage boundary and economic injury level. So, the suitable management strategy is essential to bring down the population. The example of this pest is here the locust and the leaf hopper on the sugarcane. Then potential pest. General equilibrium position always lies below the damage boundary and does not cross EIL even under favorable conditions, but there is a threat that changes in the cropping pattern or repeated intervention against the other pest may push their general equilibrium higher. That pest is called as a potential pest. For example, armyworm on wheat and mealybug on BT cotton. These are some of the categories of pests. But now, how this pest is outbreaks? What do you mean by pest outbreaks? The major concept of the integrated pest management or in insect ecology. Here, what is pest outbreaks? The phenomena of sudden increase in the pest population due to the effect of the different biotic and abiotic factors called as the pest outbreaks. But what is the actual general causes of the pest outbreaks? These are some of the 10 general causes with reasons for the outbreaks of the pest. In that, the first one is bringing the forest area under cultivation or destruction of forest. And then destruction of natural enemies of the pest, intensive and extensive cultivations, introduction of the new varieties and crops, improved agronomic practices, introduction of new pest in new area, accidental introduction of the pest from the foreign countries, large scale storage of food grains, lack of adopting IPM strategies, and resurgence of the sucking pest. Let us see one by one. First one is destruction of forest and bringing the forest area under cultivations. The insects feeding on the forest trees and plants in the forest are driven to neighboring areas where they may infest the cultivated crops and become the new pest. This is one of the reasons for outbreaks of the forest pest towards the cultivable land. Then destruction of natural enemies. This is the most serious, or we can say that the most important reason to cause a pest outbreaks, because in environment there are the number of natural enemies is there. That natural enemy check the insect pest population in the environment and maintain the balance of nature. But here, due to the continuous or excess use of the insecticide, the natural enemies are killed. This affect the natural control mechanisms and pest outbreaks occurs. Examples: synthetic pyrethroids insecticide kill the natural enemies. The intensive and extensive cultivation of the crops. Monoculture, that is the intensive, leads to the multiplication of the pest. Extensive cultivation of the susceptible variety in a large area, no competition for food multiplication is increased. For example, stem borer in rice and sugar canes. It means that the monocropping and extensive cultivation is responsible for the outbreaks of the pest. Fourth category is introduction of the new crops or improved strains and varieties. What happened in this? The new plant may serve as the new host for some of the insect species. Mostly, improved strain of the crop plants are susceptible to pest, whereas character near to their wild parents is resistant to the pest attack. Okay, the variety with favorable physiological and morphological factors cause the multiplication of the insect. For example, succulent dwarf rice varieties favors to the leaf folder in rice. Then Cambodia cotton favors stem weevil and spotted bollworm. And hybrid sorghum favors fruit flies and gall midge. It means that the new variety or the new crop is also as a source for a pest outbreaks. Then improve agronomic practices. In that, excess use or application of the nitrogen fertilizers cause a resurgence of the pest or increasing the pest population. In case of rice, yellow stem borer and sucking pest increases in rice due to the excessive application of the nitrogenous fertilizers. Then in case of cotton, the aphids and leafhoppers population is increases. Then in case of mango plantation or mango orchard, closer planting in mango increase the leafhopper populations. Then excess irrigation in rice increase the brown plant hopper population in rice. This is the improved agronomic practices that leads to the insect populations. And then this is the six reasons for pest outbreaks. That is the accidental introduction of the pest from foreign countries through the airs and sea ports. Here, if you see, this is the list of some of the insects that is migrate from other or foreign countries to our countries. That is called as the exotic pest. Some of the old introductions are serpentine leaf miner, coffee berry borer, spiraling white fly, and coconut aerophytes mites are enter into the country through the different factors, air or sea ports. Then some of the recent example like a tomato leaf miner, western flower thrips, then spiraling white fly, then solanum white fly, fall armyworm, and this is the white fly species that is introduced in our country from foreign. Then seventh is introduction of the new pest in the new environment. Why this is happen? Because pest multiplies due to the absence of the natural enemies in a new area. When due to the excessive use of the chemicals, what happens? The natural enemies of that particular pest in that particular area is decreases. Hence, the pest is stable or stabilized in that particular area. And the male, for example, apples will be multiplied fast due to the absence of the Aphelinus smiley. It means that Aphelinus smiley, it is one of the parasitoids against the apple will aphid, but in that area Aphelinus smiley population is reduces day by day, so will aphid population is increases. Sunflower and head borer. In case of sunflower, the head borer population is also increases day by day due to the absence of their natural enemies. Then a large scale storage of the food grains. This is the another most important reasons of pest outbreaks. The large scale storage serves as the reservoir for store grain pest and rats found in the underground drainage. Next one is resurgence of the sucking pest. This resurgence occurs due to the continuous use of the synthetic pyrethroids in some of the crops. For example, deltamethrin, quinolphos and forates cause resurgence of brown plant hopper in rice, and synthetic pyrethroids cause the resurgence of the white fly in cotton, and carbofuran causes resurgence of the leaf folder in rice. Okay. And then last one, and last but not least, lack of adopting APM strategies. Nowadays the farmer does not adopt the this APM strategy. Due to this, what happened? The farmers only use only one methods to controlling to control the pest, that is the chemical control. Hence, due to the excessive use of the chemical, there are the number of bad effects it is released in the release or produce on a human health, on a soil health, on a environment also. So due to this, it also also reduces the population of the natural enemies, and the balance of nature is altered. Thank you.